Children, in previous class we continued with the water we drink, right? So in this session we are going to start with the water cycle. Water we drink and forms of water we completed in our last session. Now we are going to start with the water cycle. First of all, children, what is water cycle? I want to say, see, if you open page 206, you will find it. We have a fixed quantity of water on earth. Yes, we have a fixed quantity. Fixed quantity means this much only quantity of water on earth. I said in previous session, 23% of water is a fresh water. Remaining 97% is a salt water. We cannot use that water for anything. The earth is watery by source of water. Only 3% of water is for drinking. And other water is not fit for anything. It's not good for anything. The moment nature is moving is from one form to another. So what that happens in nature? Nature itself will move from one form to another. This is called as water cycle. Nature is helping to move the water from one form to another is known as water cycle. The water in the ocean, seas, lakes or ponds are heated by the sun rays. The heat turns the water into the water vapor. The water vapor is lighter than air, thus it goes upward. In the upper part of atmosphere, the water cycle cools down and changes into small drops of water. The waterfall on the earth as rain. The rainwater through rivers and streams flows back to the ocean, seas, or lakes or ponds. Now let's explain how. First, see what we have here. We have here sun. What are these clouds? Water. Now, what is water cycle? See. Now, sun is brightening. Okay. Sun is brightening. Sun rays will fall on the water. Lake, pond, stream, ocean, anywhere. Sun rays falls on the water. Okay. If the sun rays falls on the water, this water will be evaporated. Evaporated means goes up. Vapors are lighter than the air. Air is only a lighter. Air vapors are more lighter than the air. This water goes up. This is known as evaporation. Okay. The sun rays directly fall to the water and the water forms a vapor and goes up. This is called as an evaporation. When this water goes up, okay, because of sun rays, then it will form a cloud. Okay, in sky, it will form the clouds. When all the water goes up, it will form the clouds over there. Okay, that is known as condensation. What is known as condensation? Evaporation, condensation. Taking the water, sun rays fall down on the water. Then the water goes up, forms the cloud. That is known as condensation. Afterwards, what? Now we want back more water. Already sun took our water and made clouds. Now for earth, we want water. But what will happen? Then it starts to rain. You see, when dark clouds happen, what will happen that time? Yes, it will form the clouds and it starts to rain. This is known as precipitation. Then once again it will form the evaporation, then it turns to condensation, once again it will form the precipitation. Evaporation, condensation, precipitation. Okay, evaporation means the water goes to the clouds, form the clouds, it starts to rain. When it starts to rain, our water will come back to the earth. Once again, the form will be changing. This is known as water cycle. Okay, children, I hope you understood. Next, we have clean water. We need clean and fresh water. Can you drink dirty water, children? No, right? We should always drink clean and fresh water. The rainwater is the cleanest form of water. This rainwater is the cleanest form of water, children. This, how are you feel rainwater is dirty means? Because whatever the is in your dress, some kind of dirt, mud is there, no? It will fall down, no? Then you will feel rainwater is dirty. But in nature, rainwater is the purest form of water. The river water in mountain is always fresh and clean. Yes, the river water in the mountains are always fresh and clean. But nowadays, it is not fresh and clean because people will go for trekking, right? They will throw all their waste over there. Mountaining, trekking, whatever, they will throw their waste over there. Now, base is not but butterly it is to be fresh and clean. But when it reaches to the plains, the water that we throw into the river makes dirty. Yes, when it reaches, I said no, they will go for trekking and all. When it reaches to the plains, it will become dirty over there. Thus, we have to make the water pure before using it. If you are drinking, if we are all drinking, yes, we are all drinking. Before drinking it, make sure our water should be clean and pure. If we become dirty, what will happen? Dirty water, we will get sick, first of all, our teeth won't be nice. Our body will start to get damaged, there won't be immunity at all. We'll attract lot of diseases if we have, if we drink dirty water. So always we have to boil the water and drink and purify it. How can we boil and purify? First of all, boiling it. Because boiling kills all the germs. Adding chlorine tablets. Nowadays before also, if any water is there, we'll add chlorine tablets. Chlorine will absorb all the dirt and give us a fresh water. Then filtering it. You have seen the filters, right? Aqueduct filters, water purifiers, they are all the filters. Then, how can you store the water? First of all, remember to store the drinking water always in clean utensils. Cleaning water, washing water, never mind. But drinking water should be always kept in the clean utensils. Cover the stored water in a prevent dust. Whenever the water is there, please make sure to cover with anything, with any lid or any plastic tupperware somewhere. Cover it, okay? Slices fall down and if dirt will fall down, it will become a completely waste. Drink water from a clean glass. Don't drink any from water from anything. Just whenever you are drinking the water, it will be in clean water bottle and in clean glass. Water is precious. Every day, many people in our country had to get water from far away. Yes, in villages and all, they don't have any bore wells, hand pumps, and like city water. No, they have to travel very far. Just to get the water from the well, you have seen villages in advertisement and all, right? A lady will be there, she will be carrying, keeping the pots above the pots and all. See how much she will have to go through that trouble to get the water. So water is very precious, children, and there is a shortage of water also. So make sure, don't waste the water for anything. If you see any taps are opened any nearby, make sure to close the taps. Even a single drop of water also is very precious. If the drop water will be dropping and dropping, you will lose lot of water. So make sure, if the drip of water is also, close the tap properly. Okay, children, save every drop of water because water is insufficient. How much ever we use, we are just waiting the water to get, we are utilizing the water, but we are not able to do anything to contribute the water. We can't create our own water, right? So whatever the nature has given us, we have to preserve it. Okay, children? So I hope I cleared everything. If you have any doubts, we'll meet in our interactive session. Meanwhile, I want you to take out your textbook. We'll finish your TV exercises. Okay? Page 208, children. Choose the right answers. To grow crops, farmers need what? Sky, water, air. What does farmers need? Yes, they need water. Tick mark near water. Option B. The electricity generated from water is called dash hydroelectricity, hydropower, thermal electricity. Option A, thermal electricity. The river water is mountains, garbage, dash and dash, clean and fresh. The main source of fresh water on the earth is dash. Rainfall. The dash generated from water is called hydroelectricity. The electricity. About 3/4 of the surface of the dash is underwater, earth. The water in the ocean, seas, lakes are formed as dash by the sun rays, heated. Okay, children, next comes Catholic following, which I will be sending you to the Google notes, okay, after interactive session. Okay, I have completed your textbook exercises. I'll just say a small word for you while you need water. Water is very precious. Please don't destroy you to utilize the water, preserve it, okay? We need water for drinking, bathing, cooking, washing the tiles and all, right? What are the sources of water? Ponds, rivers, rains, the sources of water. Main source of fresh water is what? Rainfall. All the living beings need water to drink. Without water, no one can survive. Without food, we can survive for at least 1 day or 2 days, but without air and water, we cannot survive, children. Okay? Then forms of water is solid, liquid and gas. First, if you put that water in that glass and if you keep in refrigerator, after a few hours you will see it performs the same. Then same shape, whatever shape you have given. Then after the solid water comes to the liquid, it will flow, then it will turn into the vapor, gaseous. Then we have water cycle, condensation, evaporation, condensation and precipitation. What is evaporation? Sun rays fall directly on the water, it will go up and will form a cloud. After that, it will start to rain. And it happens thoroughly through the nature. Evaporation, the water goes up. Condensation forms the cloud. Precipitation, once again, the water comes down and follows the same. Okay, children? Then, if we have clean water, we need to always keep the water clean. Make sure whenever you are keeping the water in any utensils, that should be covered with lid. Okay? Boiling, adding chlorine tablets, and filtering is the most easy way we can purify the water. Even if you drink dirty water, you become sick. Okay? Water is very precious. Make sure you always preserve the water. Not water, you have to preserve the nature. Okay? So children, I this much have completed your chapters. In next class, we will meet in our interactive session if you have any doubts, we'll clarify it. Make sure to complete the textbook. And after this, I will be sending you the notes after interactive session completed. Okay, children?